Welcome back, everyone. Today, we're diving into a quick and easy tutorial to master the Angular Slider component. With the Syncfusion Angular Slider component, you can quickly select values or ranges by sliding the thumb along the bar. Plus, you can easily customize the ticks, thumb, and tooltip to fit your needs. In this video, I will demonstrate how to create an Angular app and add the Angular Range Slider component to it. I will also explain how to change the types, formats, tooltip, ticks, and limits. Additionally, you will see how to customize the range slider using CSS classes. Let's start with the application creation process. I'm going to create an Angular application using the Angular CLI tool. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. In this video, I'll be coding with Visual Studio Code and checking the output in Google Chrome. To create a project in Angular, I open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the command npm install -g at angular/cli. I use the command ng new project name and name my project as my Angular app. I am going to create a project with a CSS stylesheet. So, I choose the CSS option. The project creation has started. Now let me navigate to the project folder to add the Syncfusion Angular Slider component. I install the Syncfusion Angular Slider package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-inputs --save. This will install the package along with its dependencies. And now the application is ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. So, I open the main TS file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To know more about how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. Now, the application is configured to use Syncfusion Angular components. Next, I navigate to the app component TS file and import the slider module from the Syncfusion Angular slider package. I register it within the imports array of the component section. To add styles to the slider component, I import the necessary CSS references. I have also added the dependent CSS references like buttons and pop-ups. Now let's open the app component HTML file and start adding the slider component. Remove its default content first. I add a division element with a class container to align the slider component. I add the slider component by adding the EJS slider tag. To render the slider on the UI, I need to set a custom slider value by using the value property. To do that, I define a variable named value of type number and assign 30 as its value. Then I assign this variable to the value property of the slider. Inside style CSS, I define the container class with styles like padding to align the component. Now, save the changes and run the application using the command ng-serve. Checking now, the range slider is rendered with the value 30. This is the default slider type for selecting a single value. The other slider types are min-range and range. To display the min-range slider, I set the type property to min-range. Now the slider displays a shadow from the start value to the current selected value. Next, to select a range of values, I change the slider type to range. In the app component TS file, I need to provide a range of values in the value object. I set 30 as the starting value and 70 as the ending value. Checking now, the specified range is selected in the slider. Next, I will show you how to display a tooltip in the slider. I declare an object called tooltip, and within it, I set the isVisible property to true. In the app-component.html file, I then assign this object to the tooltip property of the slider. See now, the tooltip is shown when I click the slider bar or drag the handle. In general, the tooltip is visible when I hover, click, or drag the handler on the slider. To make it constantly visible, I set the showOn property to always. Checking now, the tooltip is always shown. Notice, by default, the tooltip is shown above the slider bar. To display the tooltip below it, I set the placement property to after. Now the tooltip displays below the slider bar. By default, the slider value is changed using the slider handle. I can also change the value using buttons. To demonstrate, I set the show button's value to true. See here, the slider has been rendered with buttons. I can increase or decrease the values using them. Next, I will show you how to enable ticks in the slider. I define an object named ticks, and within it, set the small step property to 10 and large step property to 20. The small step property is used to denote the distance between the two minor ticks in the scale of the slider, whereas the large step property is used to denote the distance between the two major ticks. I can also set the placement property to after to indicate the position of the ticks in the slider. Now, I set the show small ticks property to true to show the small ticks. I assign this object to the ticks property of the slider. And now the slider displays labels, major ticks, and minor ticks. Notice that the slider displays the unit values as numbers. If you want to display a different format, use the format property. In this example, I set the format property to kilometer, like this. Here, the hash represents the unit value of the slider. See now, the ticks display kilometers. Next, let's see how to restrict the dragging of the slider to a certain range. There are 7 built-in options to limit the slider thumb to a particular range. Enabled, min start, min end, max start, max end, start handle fixed, and end handle fixed. Let's check out a few options with a quick demonstration. I define an object named limits, and within it, I set the enabled property to true. Next, let me set the min start property to 10 to set the minimum limit of the first handler. Then I set the min end property to 30 to set the maximum limit. I also set the minimum and maximum limits of the second handler. Now assign this object to the limits property of the slider. Checking the slider now, I can drag the first handler between 10 and 30 units and the second handler between 40 and 60 units. Finally, I will show you how to add custom styles to the slider. In the styles CSS file, I define the eControl wrapper, eSlider container, eSlider, and eHandle CSS classes for the slider handle, and add a custom background color and border. Now, the slider is customized. Similarly, you can customize ticks, limits, and buttons using appropriate CSS classes. That's all for the video. In this tutorial, I've demonstrated how to add the Syncfusion Angular Range Slider component to an Angular application, covering basic features such as type, ticks, tooltips, format, limits, and customization using CSS classes. If you want to interact with the example shown in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in the video description. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Angular products through our community license. If you found this video helpful, please like it and hit subscribe to stay updated with our latest content. Thanks for watching.